Hey everybody, welcome back to the channel. I'm Britt, creator of the Style Shaker, your guide to green, clean beauty, and I'm back with another product review from none other than the July mystery box. You tell me what to try, I put it all on my face, let you know what I think. Today's product, the FITGLOW Vegan Good Lash Mascara. If you wanna know what I thought about this, what I liked, what I didn't like, and if I'd recommend it to you in the future, then stick around. Green Beauty Service Announcement. If you are going from toxic to non-toxic and you are overwhelmed and you have no idea where to start, check out the free Green Beauty Guide back on the site. It is free to you and it will help you along the way. That's all I have to say about that. Let's get into the review for this mascara. This is the FITGLOW Vegan Good Lash Mascara. It is $38 for this tube. I know. I think this is 9 times out of 10, the reason I'm the one trying these is because nobody wants to spend that money if you don't like it. So, I get it, I feel ya, I try it out for you, that's why I'm here. Okay, moving on. It's supposed to be a 3-in-1 mascara. It nourishes, amplifies, it helps your lashes grow, or so it says. You're paying for it, if it works, so let's see if it works. First, I'm gonna tell you what I like about it, then I'm gonna tell you what I don't like about it, and then I'm gonna let you know what my final verdict is. What do I like? Formulation is very clean, green, love it, eco-friendly, all the good things, all the good things. My lash situation, just so you have some context here, I have lashes that are in pretty good shape, they're not brittle. I've been using quality green products on them for a while, which has significantly helped improve them. I have, I would say, a medium-sized amount. They're not super, super full, but they're pretty average. So I have like an average number of lashes and the length is pretty average. And that's just what I want you to know at the get-go. So I've been using the Honest Beauty Mascara. I use all of my mascaras with a primer. I'm using the Revita Lash Volumizing Primer. I've done a review on this as well back on the site. I believe very, very, very wholeheartedly in primers. I know it's an extra step. I know you're like, whatever, because that's how I was. But it really makes a big difference. And the other thing about primers is they can actually condition the lash. So I think this has actually been helping the growth and just overall health of my lashes as well. I'm a contact lens wearer, so you know, I'm in my eyeballs all the time. Well, not all the time. Lashes can get damaged, you know, whatever. So I think the primer is key. I use this without the primer and I also used it with the primer, so I'll give you the review either way. Just know that I've tried it both ways. The Honest Beauty Mascara goes on. It's a bit more gel-like, it's a bit smoother, and it's very much so a lengthening mascara with more definition between the lashes. I like that about Honest Beauty. This is different. However, I ended up really liking what this did. When you apply this, it looks like small, tiny fibers. The actual wand is in a cone shape, which I love. Not clunky, but it goes onto the lashes and it really magnifies. So if you have a lot of lashes and you like that long, defined, clean look, this probably isn't the best bet, but I usually like that too. And yet I use this with a primer, and so it wasn't messy looking and they are not sticking together, but it certainly makes your lashes look like they've just multiplied and you can see it instantly, which is pretty rare in mascara, let alone green mascara, because it's a tricky formula to come up with. Really, really like how it applies. I like how it stays on and it just sort of adds volume. And the last thing I wanna say is that this cone brush, you might be thrown off by it at first. I really like it, it worked for me. You just sort of, when you apply it, you wiggle it on the root, then you pull it up, and it really kind of gets in there, and that little tapered angle gets into the tapered angles of your lashes, plus it can give you that kind of nice long lash at the outside lash line. I just said lash like 800 times. You can add it and build on it on the outer lash, which I find to be one of the most flattering looks on most face shapes. Huge fan of the little cone guy. Okay, so now on to what I don't like about it. I'm gonna put this primer down because I'm not talking about it. I do find it to be a little bit pricey. I've used it for 3 weeks now, and while I can't say that I can definitively see stronger, better lashes, I don't see lashes falling out as much, which is probably a sign that there's a healthier lash bed there. Yeah, I don't know. Is the serum the big win for me? No. For me, it's really more about what it does and how it magnifies the lashes. I wish it was a little bit lower price point. Granted, I do understand this is a business and that they are trying to make money, so I don't know. All I can tell you is my opinion there is ouch on the price. The other thing that I wasn't a huge fan of is that without a primer on underneath it, it really isn't wowing me more so than any other mascara. With a primer, it's like,
whoa.
You're gonna wanna use a primer here, at least I did for the impact that I wanted on my lashes. Plus, it like never hurts to use primer, let's be honest. Final thing is, because it goes on in small little fibers, you'll see what I mean if you get it, but there was a tiny bit of flaking. I'm talking like one minuscule bit of flaking one day, but it lasts, I would say, the full day. Doesn't run down your face, but there was a tiny little bit of flaking. I'm being nitpicky, but some people freak out when anything flakes in the mascara realm, so I wanna be honest with you guys because that's how I've always been. The final verdict, would I recommend this to a friend? Yeah, totally, I would totally recommend this to a friend. This is a great mascara option. If $38 is within your budget and you're willing to spend that for a tube of mascara, then yeah, I would recommend it. I would say this is right up there with my Honest Beauty mascara. I really kind of use that as a barometer for everything else, and I've been using this one more than that. Oh. That's kind of a big deal because I've tried a lot of mascaras and very rarely do I not go back to the Honest Beauty mascara. So yes, this is a winner. I really like it, FITGLOW Beauty. I wish you could just, you know, like maybe offer 20% off more often or something. And there you go. That is the review for today. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure you give it a thumbs up to support the channel. And as always, don't forget to subscribe so you never miss another video like this one. Hello. To all of my current subscribers, my people, my tribe, my Style Shaker fam, you out there, mwah, thank you so much for being here. I really appreciate it. I'm so grateful for it. I cannot wait until we get to hang out next time. See you right back here real soon. Bye.